Hello guys and welcome back to this channel. Today is going to be a second vlog about my training, about my attempt to reach 180 meters in dynamic biofins in around 3 months. So in the last video and the last vlog I asked if you're going to be interested in such videos, and a lot of you say yes. Okay, so my pleasure to share with you my training experience. So as I mentioned on my last video about my training, I have mainly like two types of training in the pool dynamic biofins, and one it is like a volume training and one more like intensity training. So today I want to talk about the first one, about the volume training. At this moment it is a 50-minute session. It was the last session, 50 minutes. I do 44 meters and the rest between my 44 meters is 50 seconds. So this type of training at this moment is relatively easy. Even after 50 minutes, I don't feel that my urge to breathe like accumulating and getting harder. It's a little discomfort at the end, like, but not that much. So I wouldn't say that this is a like CO2 training, CO2 tolerance training. So then the question is like, why I do this type of training? And the main focus for me on this type of training is my technique. So what kind of technique I try to improve? Obviously, I trained dynamic biofins for a while. So is it like my technique already fixed? And of course not. So there is a few things which I want to improve in my technique. There is a few things which I want to add, such as like there is a slight modification of my turning. I also do small modification in my gliding. So recently I discovered that like normally my gliding starts after a few kicks. So I do like 4 kicks and then I glide. And recently I noticed that while I'm gliding, my legs is not fully relaxed. So let's say I do 4 kicks and then I glide and I feel there is some tension in my legs. So this is what I try to eliminate at this moment. Also, I work on like full body relaxation during my swim. I try to focus on my shoulder, my neck, everything on my upper body, be relaxed completely during these 44 meter swims, and working a little bit on my technique. So if, as you know, when you're kicking with your biofins, the fins supposed to move like that. However, like your fins bending slightly, and it's okay. I think it's absolutely okay, absolutely normal. However, like last time when I was analyzing the video from my dynamic, then I decide that maybe I can change it a little bit and make it slightly better. So this is my prime focus during such training, is to make my technique better. I also planning to increase slightly the volume. So from 50 meters, this was my last training, I'm planning to do like from 50 minutes, I'm planning to do 60 minutes from the next session. And when I'm gonna do 60 minutes, I'm gonna still slightly increasing intensity. Let's say now it's 50 seconds and it's super easy. And then I think I'm gonna do it maybe one more session. And then I'm gonna do 45 seconds for a few weeks, 40 seconds for a few weeks. And the goal is to have 30 seconds in between. So overall, this tool is gonna make more attempts. And also, it's gonna be progression towards the intensity, right? So this session, like now it's a primarily like a volume. There's not that much challenge for me. However, I guess when it's gonna be 30 seconds or something around 30 seconds, then I think it's gonna be also challenge. Like a CO2 challenge, like a CO2 training. Even now, like when I do 50 seconds rest, obviously I expose myself to slightly elevated CO2 level. So it's still CO2 training, but it's relatively gentle CO2 training. I don't have a strong urge to breathe. This is why it's probably like not that much CO2 tolerance training. However, there is still some CO2 tolerance improvement. I notice it. Even when I start my training, I was doing 60 seconds rest. And I think now with the 50 seconds, it's even becoming more easy, because again, as I told you, I haven't been training for a while, and now I think I'm just getting slightly better in the shape. So 50 seconds now is easier than it was 60 seconds about a month ago. And probably, guys, you notice as well, at the end of your long session, if you do like a lot of repetitions, you have a fatigue, and during this state of fatigue, you probably notice that it's harder to focus on your technique. So this is what I'm working on as well. Let's say at the second half of my training session, I feel that it's harder to maintain good technique, to maintain good posture, good streamlining position, etc., making a good turn. And this is like what is my second session is about. My second part of the session, not second session, second part of the session is how to maintain the same technique when fatigue is already kicks in, right? So this is a one more focus during this volume training. So guys, at this moment I have more trainings like that compared to the intense training, which I'm gonna discuss in my next video. So I do 3 or even sometimes 4 sessions like that, and then I do one session which is a slightly higher distance, but again, we're gonna discuss it on my next vlog video. So guys, this is it. This is how my session looks like my last session looked like. And my next session is gonna be 60 seconds, 60 minutes, still 50 seconds in between. I'm gonna do maybe 1 or 2 sessions like that, and then it's gonna be 45 seconds for a while, 40 seconds, etc., etc., until I reach 30 seconds, or maybe even lower. It will depends how I'm gonna feel these 30 seconds. And now, guys, I want to address a few comments which you put on my last vlog video. And the first comment, I was shocked. It was shock to me to know that the fellow who easily does 150 meters is training at 40 meters. Yeah, guys, it is sometimes like a little bit misunderstanding that if your distance, like if your PB is like 100 meters, then it is a kind of shame to do 20 meters. Of course not. It depends what you're training, at what part of your training cycle you are. So for me, even my distance is 170 with dynamic, like this type of training make absolute sense. I do a lot of training like that, working on my technique, but also like on CO2 tolerance, etc. Another comment, biggest issue so far has been to manage safeting in the longer session when doing 50 meter dynamic non-stop. Usually you can have a safety for a few dives like that, but to have someone look over you for an hour is difficult. Absolutely agree. So let's say if you're doing the session like that, then like you couldn't do safety for other people. So at this moment, how I dealing with it? So I'm training with a few guys in the pool, and they do more or less the same what I'm doing. And since we are doing relatively easy session for us, we're not swimming, like we're not doing actual safety for each other. And guys, this is a little bit like sensitive topic, how exactly you do dynamic safety for someone who is doing dynamic. It depends on the intensity. So obviously, rule number one in freediving, you never train alone. So whenever you train dynamic in a pool, there should be other freedivers as well. But then what other freedivers doing, it depends what is my actual plan. So let's say if I'm gonna plan to do my PB or near PB, then of course it's gonna be someone who is gonna follow me on the surface and doing constant safety for me. I'm starting to implement this type of safety when my attempts, let's say more than 60% from my max, or when it's gonna become like really hard, intense CO2 training. So at this moment, when I have this session, again, remember my dynamic is 170. So when I'm doing this type of training, then it's enough for me, for my safety, that there is another 2 freediver training in the pool. The pool is empty, there is no other people. So they constantly see that I'm coming up, I'm doing my training. So it is a safety as well. However, when the time is gonna be smaller and when it's actually become challengeable, it's gonna become a more challenge during such training, then the safety is gonna be slightly changed, and I'm gonna address it in the next video as well. So, and one more question, almost the same. Would you please talk a little bit about safety consideration for this style of low intensity, high volume training? So guys, one more time, the safety topic is not black and white. So again, the main rule in freediving, you never do training in the water alone. So this is like you don't break this rule. However, how exactly you do safety can vary. So for example, let's talk about me. Let's say my maximum 170. If I do, let's say, more than 120 meters, I would love that someone gonna swim with me all the time. Maybe not all the time, let's say start from, I don't know, like 50 meters. If I do, let's say, less than 100 meters, I would love if someone not necessarily be in the water, but let's say constantly watching me. Let's say I'm doing 100 meter dynamic body fins, I would love if someone, even not in the water, just constantly watching me, not necessarily need to swim over me. If I'm doing less than 70 meters, then I would love if someone just like checking when I finish the dive. So let's say I told this, I'm gonna tell this person, okay, I'm gonna do 70 meters dynamic body fins, and I would love when I come up, the person like have an eye on me and just making sure that I do proper recovery. But when I do training like that, for me it's enough if there is another free diver, the pool is empty, there is no distraction for other free divers, so it's only three of us in the pool, and for me it's enough if these people just see that like I'm keep going. Of course, we never know when we can become hypoxic, right? So this is absolutely true. This is why you're always supposed to assume that there is a chance of you to becoming hypoxic even during your like low intensity training. But honestly, for me, when I do 40 meters with a such long break, and again, my dynamic is 170 at this moment, the chances for me to become a hypoxic is just like zero, almost close to zero. However, not zero completely, so this is why I never gonna be training alone in the pool. So guys, believe me, I do freediving for a while. It was never ever single time when I was training in the pool alone, even doing like easy training like that, never ever training alone. So I hope this helped. If not, let me know again in comments. Maybe I gonna address it one more time in my next work session. So yeah guys, this is it. This was all of your questions, so feel free to comment in this video as well if you have any other questions. My next video is going to be about more like a intensity training. You need to do it from time to time, because if you only do a high volume training and low intensity, then it's just going to be impossible to jump in the water and do your personal best, because especially your mental preparation is going to be not enough to like deal with a lot of contraction. So this is why mainly I doing this type of training, but after each three sessions like that, I do now like one intense training, and actually it's going to be the next one. I was wrong when I was saying that this one is going to be next. No, my next session is going to be intense training, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to do 6 times 70 meters with a relatively nice rest in between, maybe like 5 minutes rest in between. But I'm going to talk about this type of training on my next vlog. So guys, again, hopefully this type of video interesting for you. And if yes, let me know in comments, and also don't forget to click the like button and share this video with your friends who maybe still haven't subscribed to my channel. This is gonna help my channel to grow, and I really appreciate when you're doing this. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video till the end, and I will see you next time.